One love.
Colorana wins the first point here of this best of five match against Patrick Francisca. Fraser Riley here, coming to you live and direct from the Infinity Arena in Montpellier.
One all.
A lot of fans will be excited about this match here. Two amazing shot makers, two counter-loop kings.
One all. Two one.
Shuffles nicely there. Patrick Francisca. Both these players quite tall. Try to protect the middle with their backhand. Smooth over the table from Francisca.
One,
Colorano three. Trying a kind of Adriana Diaz style slap. Wasn't that far away there, Colorano. You're never fully safe, even when the throw from Brazil is back in no man's land.
One and four.
Touches it. It's attackable, but it's not long. More difficult to put that away than it might look like for Hugo Colorano. Francisco impressed, beating Edward Lee of Canada in three straight games. Colorano even more so against Im Jong-hoon. Winning that with a bagel. So, neither of these two dropping a game in their round of 32 matches.
5-2.
Winner of this match will face Tomokazu Haramoto, who saved match points against Anton Shelbury in an epic clash.
3-5.
In my opinion, has the hardest shots in the game, the fastest shots. But it's about getting that blend. It's about when to use a particular shot that really matters.
3-6.
Knowing that, having that instinct. Good flick from Francisco, catches the edge though. Unreturnable for Colorano.
Seven, three.
Francisco here. With that Rolls-Royce backhand.
Eight, three.
Crowd surprised here because Calderano is always in the conversation of potential winners when an event begins. Calderano in deep trouble here in game one.
4-8.
Counter loop from Francisca.
4-9.
It's an aggressive push, good. Open up from Colorano, but got the bat high, good posture, good timing from the German.
9-5.
And that high toss serve of Colorano amazes in itself. Bit lukewarm, that receiver, Francisca. Reverse pendulum serve. Nice change.
10-5.
A point away from cashing in with the win here. Colorano not being given the rhythm that he likes to play at. Play with.
Net. 10-5.
Good receive from Colorano. Still though here, staring down the barrel of the gun.
11-7.
Beating Big Fatty for the first time.
Love one.
Now, Franziska has to expect, this could be red rag to a bull, has to expect a response from Calderano.
Let's love one. One all.
Franziska, punished for something he didn't even do wrong. Hits it like a book, that flick Calderano. Turns a new page here.
Oh.
And as soon as I say that, he misses his serve. Classic commentator's curse, ladies and gentlemen. Up a fair few balls here, Calderano. I think he's struggling a little bit with the serve, the reverse here of Franziska. Doesn't know if Franziska's going to do it long or short. That's part of the problem. We saw Franziska catch him out with a couple of long ones in game one. Beautiful. Sniffing that attack out, Calderano.
Three, oh.
Edge for Franziska.
Three, four.
Played the dummy backhand, Ugo Calderano, faking topspin. And Franziska.
Please play.
Managing to find the thin edge. Again, pops up the serve. Ugo Calderano.
5-4.
Flick. Franziska opens the body on it. So reliable with this shot, so mechanical. It's a tried and tested backhand. Calderano going for the double backhand. When he first started doing
five,
it,
six.
Seemed to be for fun. And look, it's fun to watch, but I think Calderano genuinely thinks that playing the double-handed backhand gives him some extra stability when trying to play a fish or a lob. Fun to try out for all of you watching at home. Sure you have at some point. As well as that alpha play, Calderano does have a few tricks up his sleeve. Swerve on the serve, the curve. Let's observe it here. Corduano really wanted to receive that with the backhand flick. He scuttled in to try and play it from the forehand side. Ooh, a raspy show there from Hugo Corduano.
7-4.
Did well to improvise there. He's got such a free style. He'll play forehands from backhands and backhands from forehands. And such a jack of all trades.
7-8.
Corduano is someone who sticks to the script a little bit more. And that's what makes it interesting, because I think Calderano's top level is maybe a tiny little bit better than Calderano's. I mean, saying that, is it? Because of the wins that Francisca's had are better than Calderano's top wins. Calderano's never beaten Marlon in a handful of attempts. Francisca's beaten him twice. Francisca has the best wins out of anybody.
Nine
excluding
eight.
The Chinese. Will have been disappointed to not have been selected for singles at the Olympics, especially after that Saudi smash, but perhaps still in contention for LA. He'd be 36 when that happens. Two game points here for Francisca.
Eight to ten.
Two game points here. For Big France. Oh, it was a brave serve from Calderano.
9-10.
Nice delivery. One game point remaining for the German.
Please play.
Catches the net.
Game.
So much has changed.
One love.
Calderano that beat Francisca. The Hungarian Open in 2018. 4-2. Both really refined their game since then.
Love two.
Calderano winning 9 titles. He is one of the big names to beat right now. Once you get to that level, the hardest thing to do is maintain it. Nice fade from Calderano must be playing with a little bit less pressure on his shoulders here. Beautifully done off that half long. Francisca has to just try and keep playing one point at a time. Can't afford to think about the finish line here. We know how quickly things can change. Saw that with Alexia Lebrun and Morigard earlier. Lebrun going 8-0 up and only ended up winning the game 11-9. No room for complacency here. And just got one of two Germans remaining, Benedikt Duda, with another outstanding performance, beating Quadri Aruna 3-0.
Let's. 5.
Sportsmanship from Patrick Francisca. Hit his shirt on the way through. Point automatically awarded to Uwe Kordanuk.
Five-3.
Catches him out with that long serve there. Serving straight backspin.
6-3.
All guns blazing, Colorado here. Too good there. This is where Colorado's at his best.
3-7.
Rainbow of a backhand loop. Whoa, predatory play. This is a much different Ugo Calderano now. Honed in on what he needs to do.
Nine and three.
And now then, it looks like we will be going to a fourth game. Seven game points here for the Thule from Brazil.
10-3.
Much better here from Calderano. Well, the champions Chongqing, before he played Liang Jingqin, he managed to come back from 2-0 down to Dmitry Ovcharov.
Too long.
Could have been a nasty one there for Calderano. He shrugged it off here, the Brazilian.
Too long.
It's going to take more than that to affect Ugo Calderano. Two-point game here, Calderano. Two ahead. Over the last 16 points to the Thule from Brazil.
Two, three.
Devastating power from Calderano. He's in full flow. He is basically impossible to stop for anyone other than Ma Long. Nice, Calderano. Awesome play, that mini flick that he does. That
five
little dink.
Two.
which can help get a pop-up ball. It was well received from Patrick Franziska, but that bellowing backhand belted for a winner. And again, deja vu.
2-6.
The LeBruns both through. They're going to be facing each other. There'll be no love lost and no holds bar affair in that quarterfinal. So excited for that one.
Two, seven.
In this half, the only Chinese player is Liang Jingquin. As I said before, the winner of this will play Tomokazu Haramoto.
7-3.
Stunning backhand from Kotokana. Don't know how Franziska managed to counter it like that. 8-3. Nice there. Again with this forehand. He's digging aggressively where he can. This looks a little bit kerfuffled here.
4-8.
This is probably going to go to the fifth game, and then that psychological edge, you'd have to imagine, with Ua Calderano. We talk about momentum a lot, but it's more about confidence. Eats it up. They'll have seconds there, Calderano, as well.
4-9.
Starving for a game five, Calderano.
9-5.
Beautifully timed.
10-5.
So proactive here from Hugo Calderano. 5 game points for the third from Brazil to level it after trailing 2-0. Slows 11, it right
five.
Down.
Game for Calderano.
What a start here for Calderano.
One
love. Mentioned that comeback earlier against Dmitry Ovcharov that he did at the Champions Chongqing. He lost the first two games 11-4 and 11-2. And then won 9-5 and 7. Good start here for the third from Brazil.
1-2.
Lunges in there, Calderano. Franziska with a bit of luck on his third ball backhand loop. 8-3. He's done so well here, Calderano. And this is difficult for Franziska because after going 2-0 up, he wasn't close to finishing it in game three. Calderano has looked to have been able to almost completely forget about the scoreboard. Talked about that earlier. Enjoying the process even if it doesn't go according to plan at the start. If you get through it, there'll be something better waiting for you at the end.
3-all.
All square here in this one set shootout. Short rally so far with the tension. With the fact that the players are looking to finish the point as soon as they can. Munier and Hillshire watch on. Franziska here.
3-all.
As he serves back. He'll be ahead at the change of ends.
Let 3-all.
That's a big show from Franziska. That forehand wouldn't have been possible if he didn't say to himself, I'm just going to turn this corner here because I can better impose myself with my forehand in this rally. Now I've got Calderano a little bit further away from the table. Franziska's backhand flick was phenomenal in the first two games. He managed to play it so beautifully with the Chiquita. Helped him gain an advantageous position at the table. He took Calderano out a good few times with that shot. Managed to make it more difficult for him to do that, Calderano. Well, that time, completely bamboozled. Floatier serve, still backspin, but still a little bit floatier. And Franziska with a reality check. Might have missed it in the point before, but this is still the shot I'm looking for, and it's still the shot.
4-5.
We can deliver the goods under pressure. Hit it beautifully there, the German. Head by a point as the players change ends. And again, coils that wrist back, that kinetic energy. Expels it. With that elbow high, that wrist relaxed. Pressure on the thumb. Such a great flick from Franziska. Six, four. Reverse pendulum serve and it's just a bit too attackable.
6-5.
Calderano will take no prisoners of this one. A big point there.
6-all.
Franziska's bread and butter backhand. A spinny one from Calderano. Didn't come into the backhand there, Franziska. He was staying there at the base of the table. Have to come into that, or the counter will most likely
please
go long, even if
time.
The racket
six
angle
all.
Is closed enough. Receive was fantastic from Franziska.
6-8.
How did he make space for this Calderano? Unbelievable.
6-9.
What a time to get a streak like this.
Come on. 9-7.
Not over yet, though, says Patrick Franziska. Oh, I can't touch this. Says Franziska as he dances around there with a lap of victory. Pressure here on Calderano. He'd love nothing more than to set up two match points here, the Brazilian. What will he do with his service? Oh, it wasn't a bad one by any stretch of the imagination, but Franziska, the flick merchant here. Such a good shot again. How many? We've lost count in terms of outright points won on that flick. Now the German has the serves. Who's going to earn themselves the match point here? Franziska with a match point.
10-9.